Should I start this off just like hello, or just like hey guys, like every other idiot on YouTube? Hey guys! I'm just joking, I'm messing. Hello everyone, my name's Aaron Delahaye. I'm a full-time professional artist based here in Scotland. I've been full-time now for about 7 years. I did do it part-time prior to that for a couple of years, and eventually got myself in the position where I could ditch the full-time job and be a bum for the rest of my life. In that time, I've painted an awful lot of these. These have become really popular. They've always been popular in the tourist market, which initially is where I started doing them for. But over the last sort of 3 or 4 years, they've become very popular domestically. Kind of thing that everybody just has to have on their wall. My commission list, just for Highland Cows, excluding all the other portrait work that I do, and all the airbrushing and murals, etc. that I do, my commission list just for cows is growing by the day. People are wanting different colours, different styles. It's crazy. It really is. But as long as the people out there want them, I'm going to keep painting them. Now, in terms of what styles do I do? Well, when I first started doing cows, I was just kind of mucking around drawing them, doing sort of graphite drawings. This is a print of one of the very first ones that I did about maybe 4 or 5 years ago. Probably longer than that now, I think about it. This was a pencil drawing that I did. Very common image of Highland Cow. A lot of artists have used this image to paint and to draw from. The image isn't mine, it's nothing to do with me. I'm not claiming any kind of copyright or anything like that. Far from it. I've actually done this image in 3 different ways. I did it as a drawing originally, and I've also done 2 paintings of it, and I'm actually about to do a third, which will be in the kind of natural colours like you see here. Again, that's a commission from a customer down in London that I just recently picked up just about 2 weeks ago. So I'll be doing that, hopefully doing that soon in between other jobs. We've got quite a lot going on just now. I'm in the middle of building a new studio and it's just chaos. It's normally chaos anyway, but it's a particular element of chaos at this moment in time. So that's the sort of drawing that I've done. I've done several drawings like that in various different types of cows. And you know, the prints of them do quite well, fairly shift. Also done, this is a printed canvas of one of mine, multicolour cows. The original painting of this I did about 3.5 years ago now. That again, like a lot of my original Highland Cow artwork, if it's not commissioned, it will go over to the Tobermory gift shop on the Isle of Mull and be sold there. I say this particular one done about 3.5 years ago. It's the only one I've done, you know, gave it a bash, and you know, it sold quite quickly. And then all of a sudden, somebody appears that does nothing but these quite badly, depending on your opinion. However, that certain someone seems to think that he owns the copyright on painting cows and the copyright on painting cows in a multicoloured style, which he doesn't. He's full of shit. And considering he actually nicked his idea from another artist, you know, I'm not even going to entertain the guy. But that's one that I've done. I've also been commissioned to do another multicoloured cow, which has been done. The customer's away with it and very, very happy with it. But that's not something I do a lot, obviously. I've only done 2 in that sort of style. Another one, this is one that's unique to me. This is called the Mishnishmu. Now, I have a whole range of these as original paintings. They've all sold, with the exception of one which has just arrived in Tobermory today, which will be up for sale. They all have different titles that are kind of cow and Isle of Mull related. If you don't know, these are the sort of iconic colours of the buildings in Tobermory. These are called, as I say, Mishnishmu. The other ones all have kind of subheadings, which I will go into in another video. These are completely unique to me. I've had this image that is actually copyrighted to me, as is the title Mishnishmu, that has been copyrighted as well, so no one can steal it. Because believe me, there are a shitload of unscrupulous people out there, businesses and artists alike, who will steal things willy-nilly. And as I say, the whole nonsense with the multicoloured cow is, you know, kind of a long drawn-out story. I'm not saying claim it's my original idea, because it's not. I don't know who came up with it first, but I certainly know that the individual who's doing a huge amount of business with it just now wasn't the original, and I can guarantee that. But this is one that's completely unique to me, and as I say, there's a whole range of different cows, sort of cow characters, as it were, based on this. And as I say, these colours are something that I have done that's completely original and completely unique to myself. So if you do see anyone else doing this, they've ripped it off of me. But whole point of this video is really just to show you a wee technique. It's not something I've invented, it's just a wee technique that I use. You may know of it, you may not. It will work for many different applications, but I found it quite good for doing Highland cows, and doing Highland cows fairly quickly, because obviously because they're so hairy, when you're doing all that hair, it takes a lot of time to do, and you want to make things reasonably easy for you. So I'll just grab my paint and my brush here, and I'm just going to show you this. Basically, all I do is take a very wet brush, and in this instance, some raw sienna. This is acrylic paint, by the way, it's not oil paint. Some raw sienna. Now, I don't know how well this will show up on camera, but with a very wet brush, dilute the paint right down until it's, you know, very, very transparent. Almost it looks like tea with milk in it. In fact, maybe if I try to tip this up, it's going to run everywhere, so I can't even show you. Fucking useless video, this. But yeah, just water the paint down quite a bit. Just kind of blot the brush so that when you put it on your canvas, it doesn't start running straight away. And you can do this over dark areas or light areas, but what I've done here is kind of an extreme contrast with the light and the dark. And you just take your watered down acrylic and just brush it over where you want to darken it down a wee bit. And effectively what you're getting here is a kind of translucent paint. So you can go over that, just like that. And you don't have to be that accurate, you can just away you go. You can go over dark areas and light areas with it. And what you do is let that dry, and then you can go over it and keep adding to it until you get the consistency that you want, or the depth of colours that we're. And if you've ever done any kind of custom paint, it's a bit like using a candy paint, which again is like a translucent paint. And the more layers you put down, the darker it becomes, but you still see what's underneath coming through. It's a quick wee technique, really, really simple. It might work for you, it might not. It doesn't mean it's right, it doesn't mean it's wrong. But that is basically how it works. And again, you can darken it down just by adding a little bit more paint than water to your mix. Really simple, and as I say, you can be really loose with this technique, you don't have to be precise with it. You can just literally throw the paint on, and remember obviously with acrylic to let that firstly dry properly, because acrylic will dry darker than it actually appears when you first put it on wet. So you can just brush that over, and you can keep doing a couple. It's a bit like glazing with oil paints, if you've ever done that. It's a very, very similar idea. I say quite effective, particularly for hair. And I say I found that using raw sienna, just on its own, not mixed with anything, just the water, is quite an effective colour. Because you, as I say, the more you layer it, the more darker you can get it. You're getting into the more sort of brown tones and away from the sort of gingery tones that the cows have. So they're not all that sort of colour, but you're working on that assumption anyway. But that's it. It's a quick wee technique. Hopefully it helps somebody out there. And if you have any questions, just give me a bell. I'll put my details down below, and you can find me on Facebook as well. Thanks, guys.